question bar, and again I am going to start the topic of the class 9th physics. Actually, in the previous video we had discussed about the motion and types of the motion and distance and displacement, but today we are going to start another topic. The topic is uniform motion. Uniform motion. What do you mean by the uniform motion? When a body is said to be uniform motion. Uniform motion. Said to be a uniform motion if and only if it covers equal distance with equal intervals of time. Intervals of time is called uniform motion. Uniform motion. Now let's understand the help of the graph also. Time, distance, time and distance. We will get like this kind of a graph, uniform motion. Uniform motion. Now, the next one is non-uniform motion. Non-uniform motion. Non-uniform motion. It just opposite to the uniform motion basically. A body is said to be non-uniform motion when it covers equal equal distance with unequal intervals of time. Intervals of time called non-uniform motion. Non-uniform motion. Now let's understand it is also the help of the graph. Time, distance, and this will be like this. It will be like this, and another graph also. Time and distance. Understand? Now, the next topic is physical quantity. Physical quantities. Physical quantities. Physical quantity. Quantity is the property of a physical quantity property of a material. It is also, it also can be expressed, can be expressed as, can be expressed as combination of magnitude and units of a body. Physical quantities are divided further two parts. First one, scalar quantities. And second one is vector quantities. Now let's discuss the scalar quantities. This type of types of quantities this type of the quantities can be completely expressed by magnitude only, magnitude only called scalar quantities like distance, length, area, etc. Like distance, length, area, etc. Now the next one is vector quantity. Next one is vector quantity. Vector quantity. Vector quantity. This type of the quantity can be expressed completely the magnitude as well as the direction as well as the direction called vector quantities. Like displacement, force, torque, etc. Now it was something about the today's class. Let's discuss the remaining part of the next class. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.